I had not been back there in years, but it was the last place left to look. Those lost wishes weren't the treasure I was after. Those lost wishes weren't the treasure I was after. It was not exactly as I remembered it, but it wasn't all that different either. Contraptions guarded the lost treasure. I would have to turn one and see what happened. And that's what would have happened if I turned the left switch. But since I am here, buckets, barrels, butter churns, and beds were jammed into every nook and cranny of that cave. It all seemed so familiar. Even though the bed was very comfortable, this was no time to hide under the covers.
Wait. Hold on, Grandpa. I don't remember this part of the story. Beds hanging from stalactites?
We'll get there, Gwendolyn. Don't worry. No detail in this story will be overlooked. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. As I treaded through the river of rumbling trundles, I feared I knew the source of that deafening wind. Nestled beneath a slumbering pile of teeth and claws was...
Fabled Mirror!
Oh, so you remember this part of the story.
Well, dragons are my favorite.
You want to tell this part?
Yes. King Edward sent me, the greatest knight in all of Daventry, on a quest to return his stolen mirror. A gigantic, hulking beast of a dragon was the last thing in my way to...
my way to add a shinier hat to my collection. I tried to turn that crazy contraption, but it was missing a handle. Someone tampered with it, creating some silly conundrum. Thank you. As I was saying, this was no time to take a nap. Volumes of old books with foreboding titles clutter the shelves of that strange bedroom. How to Tame a Dragon, Breaking the Spirit of Hideous Beasts, Amateur Spells to Impress Your Friends With. No books about recovering missing handles, though.
So, the missing handle was booby-trapped? What did you do?
Well, I used my cleverness to outsmart the trap. Then I used my cleverness to hide. Luckily, that half-blinded beast never noticed me in bed.
A dragon's eye must be really hard to pierce with an arrow. At archery lessons, I can barely hit a hay bale.
It is indeed a feat only for skilled archers.
What did you use to...
Dragon's chains were coiled around a gigantic switch mounted to the cave wall. This cave seemed to be filled with failed adventures. After he briefly basked in the sun, the narcoleptic dragon went back to snoring.
I'd probably sleep all day too, if Amira was my only friend. Wait a minute. Does this mean our family's immortal?
Oh.
whoever designed this trap thought they were pretty clever, but I would probably find a way to hit that unbreachable switch. The mirror called out to me. A ridiculous feeding contraption was cobbled together to keep the beast and probably its owner alive.
Grandpa!
A ridiculous feeding contraption was cobbled together to keep the beast and probably its owner alive.
You escaped with only a flesh wound.